One of my core beliefs when it comes to photography is that sharing them is a gift that you give to the intended recipient, whether it's family or friends. Now, of course, many of us share our photos on various social media platforms, but speaking for myself, I found that there's a certain fatigue that set in. With ever-present algorithms that determine which content you'll be served, it kind of is understandable to feel a certain malaise when sharing photos on social media. Now, in fact, while I do still share some new photos on my social media accounts every now and again, I found myself spending a lot more time enjoying sharing my photos directly with a core group of friends and family. One of my favorite reasons why I prefer this new form of narrow sharing is because I have way more flexibility over the experience that my viewers have, and I know that there is no algorithm to dictate what they see. Now, the reason why I bring this up is because it allows me to shine a light on one of my favorite Lightroom surfaces, Lightroom Web. I've shown a start to finish editing workflow using Lightroom Web several months ago, and I'll leave a link to that at the end of this video. But there are some very cool tools available in Lightroom Web that can provide you with unique ways to share albums with the entire world or specific people you choose. My hope is that this video will serve as a reminder that Lightroom Web is a seriously amazing experience that you can run right from your web browser tab anywhere in the world with an internet connection. And it's available to all Lightroom subscribers, so you should definitely spend some time with it. All right, let's dive in. All right, so here you can see this is Lightroom Web, and I can understand if you're thinking, wow, this looks very much like Lightroom Desktop, because it does, but you can see here we are in a Chrome browser tab. Now, I've used Lightroom Web in Safari and other browsers, but it is recommended to use Chrome if you do want to use Lightroom Web, so that's why I'm using it here. So to demonstrate the different ways that you can share photos through Lightroom Web, I'm going to use this album that I created, and it just has a collection of bird photos that I've taken over the years with different cameras. And this is another point that I want to make. It's important, but you can share photos that you've synced to your Lightroom Cloud library. So if you have local photos, you can copy those to the cloud. If you're using Lightroom Classic, any photos that you sync to the cloud will be smart previews, which should be fine. But if you do want to share full resolution photos, you'll have to export those out of Lightroom Classic and then upload them either using Lightroom Web or one of the other surfaces. So let's start with the basics of sharing. You can do this kind of sharing using Lightroom Desktop, but it is just very powerful in Lightroom Web. So I have this album here. Like I said, it's got these photos and I want to share them with the world. So to do that, I'm going to click on this button right here, this sharing button, and you'll see this dialog window pop up. The first thing you have to do is get a shareable link. Doing this will basically enable sharing of the album. Now I'm sharing the album. You can see here if I click on a folder, you can't share folders. So we're just on the album level here. And then I'm going to click on shareable link. And now you can see we have this link access dropdown. You can either basically have anyone view it who has the link, which is basically public view, or you can select invite only, where you can enter email addresses of people who you want to have access to the album. Now, the really great thing is it's not just giving them access, but they have privileges that you can control, whether they can just view, they can contribute their own images, or they can edit, which is really, really cool. Now, I'll go ahead here. I'm going to put it back to anyone can view. And then let's switch over to the settings for this shared album. So at the top here, you can see you can control, again, whether you want it public or private. Another cool thing about private is there's this option here called allow access requests. So if someone does get access to that URL, they can submit a request to you for access. So it's another way that someone can view the album. Either you give them access explicitly using their email address, or if they get the URL, they can submit access manually. So let's go ahead though. I'm going to keep this as public. And then you have other controls over the information and the options that a viewer has, like showing the metadata, showing the location. And then this third one here, allow likes and comments. This is one of my favorite things because what you're basically doing with this shared album is creating your own kind of like private social network. What are the two things that we do when we see a photo or a video or a post online? We either engage with it by liking it or we comment. Now you can do that right here. And the best part is that you can view those likes and comments right within the Lightroom as people leave them. And then let's say you want to share the ability to download photos with a client. Let's say you're sharing, it's a wedding that you shot and you want the client to be able to download them. You can enable that here. So really quickly, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy this link and I'll open up an incognito window in Chrome. Let's paste that URL. And you can see this is the album. This is the experience by default that a viewer has. I can click on an image here. I can click on the eye to get access to the metadata. And then I can comment, but in order to comment, I need to be signed in, which I'm a big fan of, just because this prevents spammy comments. And then you can click on this little heart icon here to like it. But there is way more to it here. First, a user can enable a slideshow by clicking on this icon here. And so they can have their own slideshow of the album from wherever they are, which I think is really awesome. Now, this is kind of the default experience of how to share an album. And I think it's great as it is, but there's actually a lot more that you can do. Let's go back to Lightroom Web over here. And I'm going to click on the share button again. And then I'm going to go to customize. Now you'll see there's this button that says show me. If you click on show me, basically what is happening is you're being taken to this view over here. We were in the grid view, and clicking on show me brings you to this view here, which allows you to basically further refine the sharing experience. You'll see this toolbar down here. Let's start here. I'm going to click on this up arrow so you can see all of the options. Here's where you can control different information. So you can change the title. So I can say like, these are my bird photos. And then I can also change if I just want to say Brian or anything. You can update that name field right there. You can also change the background. So you can either have this dark background or a light background by clicking on these two options here. You can change the way the grid is viewed. So here I can have this mosaic view, or I can have this other tiled view, or I can have full screen view. So where each image is shown in line. I like this kind of standard view here. I think it looks great. The other thing that you can do is you can choose a cover. So I can click on use cover as background or hero. So what does that mean? Well, each album has a cover photo and you can choose which image in an album is the cover photo. And so if we go back here and I refresh, you'll see here's the hero photo. You can also see that this was updated. And then we have our images. Also show you what it looks like as a background. So I'll refresh this and you can see the image in the background, which I think is really slick. Let's go ahead also and change this to light, and I'm going to turn off the cover image and refresh. You can see that I don't have to click save or anything. All I'm doing is making the changes and refreshing the page and the changes come in. Another thing you can do is change how the images are ordered. By default, it's capture date, but you can see all of these other options here. And then we can also further customize the experience by adding this kind of journaling option. So check this out. Let's say I want to add some more information to this album. I can click on edit over here and I can start by adding a heading like this first batch of photos were taken with my iPhone. Just something like that. And then the iPhone 15 Pro Max, whatever. But here you can see now we have kind of like this subheader. And if we refresh, there you go, it's right here. On top of that, I can further kind of control the layout of this by adding sections. So watch, if I put my cursor in between this area here, for example, let's say I want to add a section divider. I can click here and I can have another section here. So like these photos were taken in Florida. iPhone 16 Pro Max, you know, whatever you want. But now we basically have been able to break up these images into different sections. And I can continue to do that by adding more sections. So final section, Sony A7 R5. I don't know. You know what I mean? And now if I refresh, you can see that we have different sections here. So it just allows you to present, I don't know, a more customized feel for your viewers, and you can give them more information other than just having this basic title, which I'm a big fan of. Another cool thing that you can do with sharing is you can embed any album that you want onto a web page on your site as a slideshow. So I have this album over here. It has all of my edited photos, like thousands of them. And so what I did was I was able to get code that I can embed on my website to play a slideshow. So to do that, you'll go back to sharing over here, and you'll see this little code icon here. If you click on this, you'll get this code here that you can use to embed on any website that allows custom code. And so what does that look like? Well, if I go over here, I have this other tab, and this is that album that I showed you. You can see it's got 2,404 images. I can either arrow through them, or I can click on play, and it'll just scroll through all of the images in this album, which I think is really cool. It allows me to share my favorite photos with anyone I want, and I can control the access here, which is also really nice because only the images in the album will be shown. And of course, I can also go ahead and pause that. All right, so I've got one more sharing feature in Lightroom Web that I think you're gonna love. I think actually a lot of people would like this, especially once they realize that it's available. It's called proofing. Now, proofing is currently a technology preview. So if you see something in Lightroom that's under a tech preview label or early access, that just means that we're still working on that and it can change or that feature can go away altogether. But for now, it's there for you to test and play around with and leave feedback, which is very important. So let me show you how it works. So let's say this album here of birds, this is for a client, for example, or you can pretend this was an album of a wedding couple and you want to share it with them and you want to give them the ability to select their favorite ones. Well, that's where proofing comes in. And the first thing you need to do is go to your avatar on the top right here and enable that. So under tech previews here, you'll see there's this check mark called collaborative proofing. If this is deselected, then, you know, select it and click apply changes. It'll reload Lightroom and you'll have that feature enabled. And so the first thing we need to do is enable collaborative sharing so that we can share it with our client, for example. To do that, I'm going to click on this icon right here. And you can see there's nothing here because it's not enabled. To enable it, you're going to click on this share button here. You'll see a slightly different dialog pop up than the traditional album sharing. And here what you're going to do is you're going to click on enable proofing. Now you'll get a link just like we did before, but here's something that's really cool. You can limit how many selections someone has to make. Before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and click on the clipboard here so we can copy the URL. And now let's open up a new incognito tab. I'll paste the URL and you'll see we will have our album pop up. And now we also have these check marks. And so if I click on one, you'll see that you actually have to sign in. Again, I think this is a good thing. It controls spam. So I'm going to go ahead and click on sign in and I'll sign in with my account. All right, we are now back in our album here. I'm signed in with my test Adobe account and I can go ahead and click on a check mark and you'll see that a photo has been selected. I can also click on the image here and I can leave a comment. So I can say, this is amazing and click post comment. You'll see there's the comment. Now, if we go to Lightroom Web and refresh, you'll see that this image was selected. I can also choose to see which activity I see. By default, you'll see all activity, but if you share this with multiple people and they log in, you'll see each of the people listed here. If I click in here, you can see there is the comment. Now, let's say I want to limit to 5 selections. Well, I can go ahead, click on the share icon, click on this preference, and I'm going to select 5. Now I'll go back here. Let's close out and I'll refresh. Now watch, when I click here, you'll see up there 2 of 5 selected. If I select 3 more, 5 of 5 have been selected. And now I can't click on any other image. And so there you go. Of course, I mentioned it would be great if you shared your feedback with us, whether you are the one sharing the proofing album or you're the recipient of it, you can click right down here. Also, if you go over here in Lightroom, you can click on this little chat bubble here if you want to share your experience with us. It's very helpful. So now here, if I refresh, you'll see here are the 5 images that were selected. And again, if there were multiple people, I can filter by those people individually. And then of course, as the recipient, I can change my mind. I can deselect that one and then select this one instead. And then I can go back here and refresh. And you can see that the selected images have changed, which is super cool. So imagine if you were a wedding photographer and you shared this album. Remember, you can click on any of these images, get all sorts of information, and then you can allow your client to choose their favorite ones. So I hope that this kind of really excites you to at least check out Lightroom Web, especially if you are already a Lightroom subscriber. You have access to it, so check it out. Of course, Lightroom Web is just one of the three cloud-based Lightroom surfaces. You've got Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Mobile, and Lightroom Web. If you want to learn absolutely everything there is to know about that, check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. It's got almost 11 hours of easy-paced lessons that'll teach you everything you need to know about it. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. I also have this video here I mentioned where I walk through an entire start-to-finish editing workflow using Lightroom Web. Check that out so you can see how powerful it is. And as always, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is appreciated, as is clicking on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.